Hey everyone, this is Richard.
And this is Linda.
Welcome to the Day Zero Gamer Infinite Lives show. This is show number 118 for February 16th, 2014. So, apart from gaming this week, I've been rewatching, well, it's like rewatching the Batman animated series.
Nice.
Seems like I mention that every few months or something like that. I really love the show, and I don't know, for whatever reason, I just felt like popping it in, and you know how it is. Once you start something, it just keeps going, especially the series when you have it in its entirety.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I think I'm probably going to start the movie, the theatrical movie, Mask of the Phantasm. Might have to do that later on this evening. We'll see. We shall see.
Yeah, I definitely know what you mean, because I started re-watching Avatar, The Last Airbender. So
nice.
I just wanted to see this part real quick because I was trying to remember a scene from one of the episodes.
Mm-hmm.
And now I'm like, you know, 10 episodes in.
Yeah. Then you might as well watch the whole thing.
Yeah. And then, of course, I started in the middle, so I'm going to have to start over rewatch from the beginning. So it's a rewatch.
It's funny how that happens.
Yeah. No kidding.
I mean, even for me, I think the rewatch is probably incorrect. I mean, I've seen this so many times, more than like 3 times. But
if you love it, you love it.
That's true. Nice. All right. Well, let's start the show. So what is coming out for this next week?
Tuesday, February 18th, Earth Defense Force 2025 comes out for the 360 and PS3. NASCAR 14 comes out for the 360 and PS3. Rayman Legends comes out for the Xbox One and PS4. And Donkey Kong Country Tropical Freeze comes out for the Wii U. And that's all I have to report for this week.
Alrighty. So, this week, in terms of what I've been playing, I've been playing some Call of Duty Ghosts, trying my best to max out one of my squad mates, or squad members. I wish it was a double XP weekend, truthfully.
I wish every weekend was double XP weekend.
Yes. It'd make it easier. But yeah, I've been having a lot of fun enjoying that, and I've been really still enjoying the Onslaught maps.
Yes.
Apart from that, I played some more of The Legend of Zelda Phantom Hourglass. I played more Borderlands 2, and I got in on the Titanfall beta.
Very nice.
It's really, really chaotic right now, just because I'm still trying to get used to it. Feels good, runs really smooth, and the action, like I said, is just, it's crazy. One part, though, I have to mention this, was pretty awesome. I was in a Titan, and I was getting attacked, and my Titan was going to explode, so I ejected out, shot me straight in the sky.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm skydiving down, and I saw another Titan, an enemy Titan. And so I positioned myself to land on the Titan, which I did, got on top of it, started shooting it to blow it up, and then right as it's going to explode, that pilot ejects out, which propels me up in the air with him, or her, I guess, him or her. And so both of us are skydiving back down towards the ground, shooting each other.
Man, that's
crazy.
Epic.
Yeah, I mean, you'd have to see it, of course, to really appreciate it or experience it. But things like that are just, they're nuts. I can't wait to see what else this game can do because you know how it is. The more you play it, the more things happen, the more you see other people doing things. So
yeah.
So far, I'm having a lot of fun with it.
That's so awesome.
So that was my week. Enjoyed all of those games for sure. How about you?
I also got to try the Titanfall beta. That was pretty cool.
Mm-hmm.
I played a ton of Call of Duty Ghosts.
Nice.
And, of course, Animal Crossing New Leaf. I'm working on getting more fortune cookies and filling out more bingo cards as I go.
What about the ice furniture?
Oh, I've gotten so many of that. It kind of sucks because I started running out of room, so I had to decide what to get rid of. You know how hard that is? But I have so much ice furniture now. It's taken over my entire, like, main room.
Well, I guess that's kind of cool.
No, I'm having a blast.
It was cool. Ba-dum-tsh.
Very nice. I need more money so I could expand my other rooms. There's just not enough room. It's so frustrating.
Yeah.
So I'm trying to, like, up my my housing points. So
at least you can expand it, though.
Yeah, it's just going to take a while because I just added a basement and then I slowly had to put away all my game stuff because I have a foosball table and a tabletop game. It's like the coolest thing. And I have a few other things, but I had to put all of that away because there's no room. So it's just, I still owe like 400,000 bells.
Wow.
Yeah, I think I owe 400,000 and I have 100 deposited in the bank. See, dang. What I do is I don't pay it off. You know, I don't put my money to pay off the loan. What I do is I put it in the bank because I think at the end of every month, you get interest on the bells you have in there. So until I have enough to pay off, I just keep it all in there. And then as soon as I have enough, the moment I want to expand or something, I pay off my loan and then start over.
Well, that makes sense.
Yeah.
Pretty smart.
Might as well earn interest.
Yeah.
So, yes, I've been obsessed with that. Can you tell?
Just a little bit.
And on top of all that, I also played some Borderlands 2.
Awesome. Okay, let us talk some news. So Infinity Ward, they have confirmed several new DLC items for Call of Duty Ghosts. And that is going to be arriving this Tuesday. The first is personalization packs. They're going to be costing $1.99 each and are going to include a weapon skin, player patch, player background, and reticle. The packs are going to be Circuit, Ducky, Inferno, and Space Cats. So a little bit different than the different kind of camos, I suppose, that are more traditional, but...
Yeah, just a little.
Still, more content is good.
Always.
Second is going to be squad member skins of single-player characters. So Elias, Hesh, Merrick, and Keegan. And those are also going to be $1.99 each. Then, the extra slot pack is also going to be available. So that's going to be $1.99. It's going to increase the number of loadouts from 6 to 10.
Mm-hmm.
The last one is the super awesome cool one, because for $3.99, you get the Captain Price Legend Pack.
Yeah.
Fantastic. It's going to provide a Captain Price skin, weapon skin, patch, background, and a reticle. And get this, the reticle is going to be his mustache.
I know, I love that.
It's just fantastic.
Price is so awesome. I'm very excited.
That one I'm going to have to pick up.
Yes.
Captain Price, he's like the Obi-Wan of Call of Duty.
Yes. I think that's a great description of him.
Gotta have him. Speaking of Call of Duty, this year's version is going to be developed first on the Xbox One and PS4. And then ports from those versions are going to see releases on other consoles rather than the other way around or joint developing, you know, creating them both at the same time. Which is nice because now that we have these next gen, which are now current gen consoles, we can start seeing some games created for them. So that's exciting.
Yes.
Next, Nintendo has announced that Game Boy Advance games are going to arrive on the Wii U Virtual Console this spring. So that's pretty neat. Mario Kart 8. So that game is going to be available on May 30th. And to wrap up the news here, Little Mac has been announced as a contender for the next Smash Brothers. And that pretty much brings us into the retro game. Because speaking of Little Mac, retro game for this week is Mike Tyson's Punch-Out. Or I guess it could be just Punch-Out. Both versions. Either or. Whichever makes you happy. And this is for the NES.
Yes. Punch-Out.
So for me, first time playing Punch-Out was in the arcades.
Really?
I didn't actually play the Nintendo version until a little bit later. Which is kind of interesting because the NES version looks completely different than the arcade.
Yeah, I've only ever played it on the NES. So I don't know how different it is.
The one in the arcades, it was like a green wireframe for your guy.
Mm-hmm.
And it was more, I'm not going to say first person, it was behind the shoulder. Well, behind the back. I mean, you could see your guy. And then because it's a wireframe, you can see through your guy and then see your opponent. It's different because on the NES, you have Little Mac, which I guess he's appropriately named because he's small. But you see him and then you see your opponent and he's much bigger.
Yeah, the perspective is really exaggerated. So.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm.
Or he's just super small.
Or that. I always imagined it as
the perspective.
Exaggerated. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But then you got to remember, though, back in those days, the arcade versions were super, super superior.
Yes.
To home consoles. I mean,
mm-hmm.
that was going all the way through until, I'd probably say, the Dreamcast. I mean, Soul Calibur, in my opinion, kind of changed that. Soul Calibur on the Dreamcast looked amazing compared to the arcade, and that's where that whole thing shifted. But yeah, before that, it's like, oh my gosh, is this arcade perfect? Wow. You know, it's crazy to think back that arcades were the ones that were so much better.
Yeah, I know.
But the cool thing about the Nintendo version, though, talked about Mike Tyson's Punch-Out, was that Mike Tyson, he was the boss.
Yeah.
It's crazy.
Totally.
I mean, especially looking back now.
Oh, I know. after everything. It's like, man, that's Mike Tyson.
Yeah. And then, of course, once they lost the license, they couldn't use him anymore. Mr. Dream, which was the character that they created, he took over as the boss spot.
Yeah.
Game was pretty darn hard. The boss,
no
specifically
kidding.
Mike Tyson, was ridiculous. And Mr. Dream. But...
See, I had a hard time because you have to watch the pattern. And you have to, like, study your opponent in a way. So you got to dodge and block and stuff so that you can tell what's going to happen when he's open so you can hit him.
Yeah.
But I always got too impatient. And I'd always get knocked out, and I hate trying to get back up.
Yeah.
Oh, my gosh. It's like, come on! Like, that's where button mashing is, like,
of course.
Extreme. And it's like you're watching the referee count, and it's like, come on, come on, stand up! Oh, I had so much fun with that game, but all I can remember is just getting so impatient and then getting angry because it's like, come on! And then you know you were impatient and you swung too soon. But you still get angry about it.
Of course.
But yeah, that game was surprisingly hard. It looked simple, but you really actually had to know what you're doing.
Yeah, it's, I mean, the patterns like you were talking about, once you learned them, when you go through it again, it's not so hard, but...
But trying it for the first time, you're like, you know,
you get your butt kicked. Yep. Punch-Out is one of those games that you can still go back to, and it's been a while, you may not remember that pattern, or if you do, maybe it'll come back to you when you're playing, but it's still fun. I guess that's the most important part.
Definitely.
With that, wanted to thank everyone that took the time to listen to the show. Be on the lookout next Sunday for show number 119. Special thanks to Random Junkies for providing Disorganized Fun for the Infinite Live Show theme song.
Have a great week, everyone.